Hey there, and welcome back to 365 Data Science. Today, we're tackling one of our most commonly asked questions, where should I start learning data science? And more specifically, can I learn the basics in just 30 days? The short answer, yes. You absolutely can learn the foundations in a month if you focus on the right skills. Let's break down what's realistic, what you should skip for now, and a practical roadmap to get you started. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly where to begin your data science learning journey. Setting realistic expectations. First, let's get real about expectations. In 30 days, you won't become a fully fledged data scientist with a six-figure salary. That's just not realistic. But you can learn enough foundational skills to land your first data analytics internship, develop skills for a promotion at your current job, start working on personal data projects, or build a foundation for more advanced learning. The key is to focus on practical skills that yield immediate results rather than trying to learn everything at once. We're aiming for fluency, not mastery. That comes later with practice and experience. One other consideration to keep in mind is that you don't need a specialized degree or background in this field. All the skills I'm about to share are beginner-friendly, so you can start learning today. Now, let's get into the central part of the video, skills you can learn in 30 days. Let's look at the six core skills you can realistically learn in your first month. Number one, Python basics. Python makes working with data easy. It may seem complicated at first, but it will make every other step of your journey much more straightforward. Think of it as a calculator on steroids. You'll want to learn syntax, variables, loops, and especially pandas for data manipulation. It enables you to automate tasks and analyze data that would be impossible in a spreadsheet. Number two, Excel. Although Python is an essential tool, don't overlook Excel. Nearly every company uses it, making this skill immediately useful. Focus on functions, pivot tables, and creating simple dashboards. Excel is also excellent for explaining findings to non-technical colleagues. Number three, SQL. SQL is like having a search engine for company data. Learn basic commands like select, where, group by, and join. This allows you to extract exactly the data you need from databases without having to download huge files. Number four, data cleaning. Real-world data is messy. Learn to handle missing values, fix formatting issues, and prepare data for analysis. Without the skill, your analysis could lead to entirely wrong conclusions. Number five, data visualization. Humans understand pictures better than numbers. Focus on tools like Tableau, Power BI, or even Excel charts, as well as Python's Matplotlib. This skill helps you tell stories with data and identify patterns you'd miss in raw numbers. Whether or not you're aiming for a data scientist role, this skill has applications across almost every job. You can impress your boss with clear, data-driven insights. Number six, descriptive statistics. Statistics are the real foundation behind data science. Learn to calculate and interpret mean, median, standard deviation, and correlation. These basics help you accurately summarize data and avoid common analytical mistakes. And here's a bonus skill if you have extra time. Become familiar with such cloud platforms as AWS, Azure, or Google Cloud. We've found that these skills are booming in the job postings this year. Even basic knowledge gives you a massive advantage in the job market. What to skip for now? Equally important as knowing what to learn is recognizing what to skip at the beginning. These advanced topics demand a strong foundational understanding beforehand. Let's take a look. Number one, machine learning. We know this topic is exciting, but it requires a deeper understanding of statistics and programming knowledge. You'll need to master the other skills we discussed earlier first. Number two, neural networks. These need specialized math knowledge and months of study. Number three, big data tools. While a significant part of the data engineering role, Hadoop and Spark are overkill for beginners. Number four, AI. This broad field encompasses many complex disciplines, including machine learning, computer vision, and natural language processing. Each of these subfields deserves months of study on its own. That being said, these aren't never-learned topics, they're not-yet topics. Build your foundation first, then circle back to these. Now, let's examine how to turn these skills into an actionable learning plan. your 30-day learning roadmap. Here's a practical week-by-week breakdown. Be sure to take screenshots of this plan for easy reference throughout your learning journey. In week one, learn Python fundamentals. During week two, get started with SQL and Excel. In week three, explore the basics of statistics and visualization. Finally, in week four, complete your first project. Here's how to accelerate your learning. If you wish to make this process even simpler, consider a structured course like our Data Analyst Career Track at 365 Data Science. It includes all these skills in a logical progression with projects to build your portfolio, all in just 10 comprehensive courses. The advantage of a structured path is that you don't waste time figuring out what to learn next. It's all laid out for you with practical exercises that build on each other. Try it out for free at the link below. Keep in mind that learning data science in 30 days is just the starting point, not the final goal. These foundational skills will build the momentum you need to tackle more advanced concepts as you progress. What's the biggest obstacle you're facing as you begin your data science journey? Let me know in the comments. If you found this content helpful, please like and subscribe for more practical data and AI career advice. Don't forget to share your projects on social media and tag 365 Data Science. We're excited to see what you've built. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.